3.1, we're talking about functions. You guys have heard the word function a gajillion times. This is in function notation. What is f of x a fancy way of saying?
Y.
Good. So this is in function notation, a function of x. What that means when they have a question like this, it says f of negative 2. What do they want me to do with negative 2?
Plug it in.
That's it. So if you have a question and it says, what is f of negative 2? Well, I'm going to take the original equation. So I'm going to say 3, and then I'm going to plug in negative 2 squared plus what? Negative 2 minus 5. Order of operations, what do we do first? The exponent, good. So 3 times 4, right? Minus 2 minus 5. Multiplication? Mm-hmm. So 12 minus 2 minus 5. What's 12 minus 2? 10, and 10 minus 5 is 5. So when I plug in negative 2, I get out 5. That's evaluating. Right? Okay, same thing here. Now what am I going to plug in? So I have 3 times 0 squared plus 0 minus 5. What's 0 squared? Whoa, times 3? 0 plus 0. 0. What's 0 minus 5? So f of 0, when I plug 0 in, I get out negative 5. Right? You guys with me? Mm-hmm. Okay. So same thing here with 4. I'm going to say 3 times 4 squared plus 4 minus 5. 4 squared is 16. Everybody know 16 times 3?
36.
Bigger?
30.
48. Good. So 48 plus 4 minus 5. How do I do this now that I have addition, subtraction all in one line? How do we read? Left to right. So how do we work?
Left to right.
What's 48 plus 4? 52 minus 5 gives me 47. So f of 4, when I plug in 4, I get out 47. Correct? All right, now we come to this one, and it's immediately so much harder because it's a what? It's a fraction. So can we still do it? No. Should we just skip it and cry?
Yes.
Okay, that's what most of you will do. Appreciate it. So I plug in 1/2, so I have 1/2 minus 5. Guys, when you square a fraction, right, that 2 is outside of the parentheses. Where does that 2 go? To both. Good. To both the numerator and the denominator. So this is really 3 times 1/4 plus 1/2 minus 5. What's 3 times 1/4?
It would be 2/4.
What's 1 squared?
Wait, but would it be two over four?
What's 1 squared? One. We're not multiplying. It's confusing, I know, a little bit, because 2 times 2 is 4 and 2 squared is 4, but you square the number. You times it by itself. So I have 3/4. Now, guys, we're going to get a little fancy here. Change for me 1/2 into fourths. Look, if I change this to fourths,
2/4.
It's plus. Good. 2/4. Good. Fancy again. I'm going to change 5/1. To fourths. If I multiply the bottom by 4 to get to 4, what do I do to the top? Good job. See? There was absolutely no crying involved. I'm so proud of you guys. Do I have the same denominator the whole way through now? Yes? So I just rewrite my denominator and I work left to right. What's 3 plus 2?
5.
5 minus 20?
Negative
15 fourths. Perfect. Good job. Okay. Happy Friday. Okay, moving on. Oh my gosh, it's a word problem. So therefore, what do we do?
Skip it.
Skip it. Good. Cry. Good. What else? Go home. Okay, wonderful. Take the L. Drop out. Okay, good. All right, what we're really going to do is we're going to answer the question because you all can handle it. This is just talking about a cell phone plan. This should make sense to all of you guys. I don't know how many of you pay your own cell phone, but you know what a cell phone plan is. You do?
No.
Oh.
I
was going to be impressed for a second. Guys, what this is called, does anybody know what this kind of a function is called? You guys learned about it last year.
Piecewise.
Piecewise. Ms. Carver, you're so smart. This is a piecewise function. We're going to talk.
It right there.
Well, I know. We're going to talk. You're so smart too, Chuck. I wonder if that messed anything up. Oh, well. Now we're going to evaluate again. I want us to plug in, but what are we plugging in this time?
Letters.
We're plugging in letters. Okay, this is where we're going to work on our algebra skills a little bit. What do they want me to plug in for letter A?
What?
The first one.
Oh.
What do they want me to plug in?
A.
A. So instead of X, I'm going to say, okay, every time I see an X, I'm going to plug in just the letter A. So it's going to be 2A squared plus 3 times A minus 1. Can I do anything with that? You mean factor it?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to factor it?
Yeah.
If I evaluate, all they really want me to do is just leave. Can I combine like terms? Let's put it that way.
No.
No. Can I factor this? If they wanted me to factor it, can I factor it? 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. Are there factors of negative 2? That'll give me a negative 2 when I multiply, but a positive 3 when I add?
Positive 2,
no. Nope. So we're just going to leave it just like this, because all they want us to do is just plug in and leave it. But what I'm showing you guys here is when you plug in letters, you're not going to get a numerical answer, because you can't combine terms.
Would it be wrong if you don't write F of A?
No, I probably won't mark off, but I'm going to remind you guys a million times to do it. So here, what do they want me to plug in?
Negative A.
This is going to change some things a little bit, guys. Look, I have 2 times negative A squared, then what?
Minus 3A.
So plus 3 times negative A. I agree with the minus 3A. Good. Minus 1. So again, if you square a negative number or a negative thing, what does it become?
Positive.
So I have 2A squared, then what?
Minus
3A. Perfect. Minus 1. Are these two answers exactly the same? No, and they shouldn't be because you plugged in different things. Good. All right, let's look at C. God bless you. We'll come back to D on Monday. But let's look at C. What are we plugging in every time we see an X?
A plus H.
A plus H. So watch. Watch how I do this. 2 times A plus H what?
Squared.
Plus, good, Borja, 3 times A plus H, then what?
Minus
1. All we're going to do here, guys, is combine what?
Like
terms. So the first thing I'm going to do, what does it mean if I have A plus H quantity squared?
That means the A and the H squared.
Nope.
It would be, what do you mean quantity squared?
It's that whole parenthesis squared. It's not just...
Yeah, everything inside the parenthesis squared.
Nope. Because I have a plus sign in the middle. What? How would you guys figure this out? How would you figure that out? What would you tell me to do?
Square root.
No.
X minus 2 times X minus 2.
Same thing here, guys. Same rule applies. Yes. Just two letters. It's okay. I'll walk you through it. So I have A plus H times A plus H plus. What's this 3 out here going to do? Okay, so we can go ahead and do that. 3a plus 3h minus 1. All right, so let's just FOIL. What's a times a?
A squared.
Good. What's a times h?
Ah.
Borja, good job. What's a times h again?
Ha.
Ha. You're right. Ah. I'm just going to write it as ah so they're in the same order. And then what's h times h?
H
squared. And then we still have plus 3a plus 3h minus 1. And now we combine what? So I have a squared plus, how many ahs do I have?
Two.
I have 2 of them. Plus h squared plus 3a plus 3h minus 1. I will in 1 second. I'm just taking like every little step. And now what do I do?
Distribute
the 2. Good. So 2. A squared plus what?
4AH
plus
2H squared
plus 3A plus 3H minus 1. And the last thing we look to see if we can do is combine. Okay. So just go piece by piece. Look at the first term is 2A squared. Is there anything else that has an A squared? No? Okay. So look at the second one. AH. Is there anything else that has an AH? Nope. H squared. Is there anything else that has just H squared? Nope. Is there anything else that has just an A? Anything else that has just an H? Anything else that's just a plain old number? So there's our answer. Very good job. Okay, first time you guys have seen that, I don't expect that. Oh, okay, I get it, super easy. We're gonna practice this. That's why next week I set aside literally 2 or 3 days of just practicing two sections. You're welcome. All right, like I said, we'll come back to D. I'm not trying to do too much right now. All right, last thing I wanna talk about is domain. Let's write ourselves some notes here. No, I don't like that. Okay, guys, with me. 5 more minutes. Domain. What is the domain? What am I talking about when I talk about domain? X or Y? X values. X values. X values. If you have a linear function, it doesn't actually have to be linear. When I say linear, I mean all written on the same line. But if you don't have a denominator or a square root, your domain is going to be all real numbers. That means I can plug anything in I want, negative, positive, or zero, and I'll get an answer out. But you're going to have some restrictions. So here's our 3 restrictions. I want you to write it down. If there's a variable in the denominator. Okay, there's a variable in the denominator. The way you figure out the domain is you're gonna set the denominator, set the denominator not equal to 0. Why would I set it not equal to 0? Cannot have 0 in the denominator. Good, Hayden. Very good. Okay, that's our first restriction. And we'll talk about this a little bit and then we'll be done. My second restriction is a square root in the numerator. If you have a variable that's underneath a square root in the numerator, guys, just think about this. This makes sense. It should make sense. If I have a square root and I want to find real answers, what kind of a number can I take the square root of and get a real answer? What'd you say, Borja?
Positive,
good. Can you take the square root of a negative number and get a real answer? So if you have a square root and it's in the numerator of a fraction, you have to set it greater than or equal to 0. Can you take the square root of 0?
Nope.
Yes. What's the square root of 0?
0.
You're good.
Uh-huh. Like, I remember last year, they were telling me, the square root of something.
Okay, that's good. All right, last thing we're going to talk about. And the third restriction is if there is a square root with a variable in the denominator.
These are all things you can do.
Yep, these are 3 things we got to pay attention to. So listen, guys, if there is a square root in the denominator, what did we just talk about? You can take the square root of what?
Positive
numbers and 0, right? Mm-hmm. But what happens if the variable is in the denominator? The denominator can't be what? Can't be 0. So in this case, you have to set your square root just greater than 0. Cannot be or equal to. So these are our 3 restrictions. And again, I promise you, we're going to work on this a lot for the next couple days. I promise. That's his job. Okay, look at this first one. We got to run through. What are our 3 things that we have to worry about? What are the 3 things that I look for? First thing I'm going to look for is, if there a what? Is there a variable in the denominator? Is there? Yes. So what do I have to do? What did we say we have to do if there's a variable in the denominator? We have to say, okay, x squared minus x cannot be 0. Because whatever makes x zero, we have to say in our domain, whoa, that can't work. So how would I solve this? Pretend it's an equal sign. How would I solve this?
Add x to that
equal. No. Not equal to one. Guys, factor that. What do they have in common? Okay, take out the x. I'm left with x minus 1, right?
Yeah.
So x cannot be 0, and x cannot be what number?
+1.
X cannot be positive 1. It can be anything else in the world. Anything negative, anything positive. But what happens when the denominator becomes 0?
It can't be.
Look, if I say x squared minus x, if I plug in 0, what happens? It becomes zero. What happens when I plug in one? What's one squared?
One.
And one minus one is?
One.
One minus one is?
Zero.
So your domain would be anything in the world from negative infinity to what number?
Negative.
No.
Infinity?
No. What numbers, or what are the two numbers we can't use?
One and zero.
Okay, so you can use negative infinity to zero. You can use zero to one, and then you can use one to infinity. Can you include any of those numbers?
Nope.
No. But I can use any number in the world except for zero and one. And again, I'm telling you guys, I'm gonna give you practice time on this, I promise. Let's look at this. What rule does this break?
Positive that.
Okay, a variable under the square root. But where is it? Is it in the numerator or is it in the denominator? Okay, if it's in the numerator, then I know I'm going to say has to be greater than or equal to 0. Got to be bigger than 0 or it could equal it. So, guys, solve this. How would you solve this? Well, how do you get the square root to go away? Okay, you got to square both sides. So 9 minus x squared greater than or equal to 0. Now what?
Add 9.
Subtract 9 from both sides. So I get negative x squared is greater than or equal to negative 9. Now what?
Divide by negative 1.
Divide by negative 1. What are we dividing by?
-1.
What are we dividing by?
-1.
What are we dividing by?
-1.
So what do I do with my inequality sign?
Flip it.
Yes. So x squared greater than positive 9, right? Good. So then I say x squared greater than what? I'm sorry, not x squared, just x. If I take the square root, x greater than?
Can it be equal to 0?
Less than or equal to what?
3.
Not just 3.
Plus or minus
3. Just leave it like that for now. I'm going to do two more examples, and then we're done. What rule is this breaking?
All of them.
Okay, we can look at it like that. The square root's on the bottom. So I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to change that to an x. Plus 1 has to be what than 0? Just greater than. Good. Can it be equal to? Can it be equal to? No, why not? You're right, but why not?
Because
you can't have 0 in the denominator. So I'm going to square both sides. So x plus 1 greater than 0. Now what?
Subtract
1. So x it has to be greater than?
-1.
I can use any number in the world that is what? Bigger than?
-1.
So you can go -1 to infinity. Perfect. All right, one more thing. I want to do one more example, and then we're done. What's my domain here?
Okay.
Think about the rules. Is there a variable in the denominator?
No.
No. Is there a square root?
No.
No. Is there a square root in the denominator?
Mm-hmm.
No. So what numbers can I use here? Every single number. I can use everything from negative infinity to positive infinity. We say all real numbers. That's not a trick question, guys. Can you plug in a negative number for X and get an answer of something?
No.
Yeah. Why not? You can cube a negative number and then square a negative number and then add or subtract a negative number. Can I plug in zero and still get an answer? Yeah. Can I plug in a positive number and get an answer?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have to, you guys got to get these rules in your brain. And we're going to talk about this more, but there's three major rules. You cannot break those rules. If it doesn't break those rules, then you're good to go.